Welcome to FirstFleet tenFour.
Welcome, everybody. We're glad to have you back to another FirstFleet tenFour podcast and a Wellness Wednesday episode. I'm Mark McKnight.
And I'm Elizabeth Windham.
And we are glad that you're with us, both audio-wise and video-wise again.
So exactly.
I think we survived this first episode.
Oh,
so,
I wasn't a fan.
We came back for more brutality to stare into a little bitty camera again.
We do this for you, not for us.
That's right. Our families won't watch, but hopefully somebody will.
Maybe. We'll see.
But again, thanks again for coming and for being here. And
we get to talk nerdy science, Helen Health stuff. It's going to be great.
That's right. Nerdy science stuff that we're not scientists.
That's right.
And we are not medical professionals. So make sure you understand that we are not medical professionals.
Right. We work for a trucking company.
We just really like this stuff.
Yeah.
And we're here for you.
That's right.
So again, hopefully we can provide some kind of information to kind of help give you some takeaways to when you make those next selections for eating healthy. And that was kind of our lead in to the topic last time was, what does it take to get the 99% of our participants in Virgin Pulse? What is it going to take to get those that are interested into eating healthy to actually eat healthy?
Actually do it, yeah.
Yeah. So we covered calories last time, which is basically calorie is energy.
Yep.
And a calorie can come in lots of different forms.
But try not to drink your calories.
Don't drink your calories.
Yep.
Eat really good whole foods.
Yes, if at all possible.
Yeah, and that's what we're going to talk about a lot of that today in these next couple of episodes is.
And we also discussed how those little rolly things in truck stops freak me out. And
yeah.
So, you know.
Yeah.
The basics of food.
They smell good and they are very drawing. They're very attention drawing.
They draw my attention.
I mean, what I do when I go in, because we always stop at truck stops when I'm traveling, and I've traveled a bunch the last 5 weeks. So I'm always stopping at one of our partner truck stops that we use. And you walk in and you can, I may be going towards, you know, restroom or something like that, but you're almost like you're drawn towards the walk by. You have to walk by those little things.
You just have to stare at
any truck stop.
Yeah. Yeah, you do. It's like a requirement. Okay.
So, but what do we need to, what do we want to eat and what do we want to use to, and try to get to where we're avoiding?
And they're called,
some of those.
And we're going
to
talk about one of the basic macronutrients today, correct?
Yes.
So there are three.
There's three macronutrients.
Macronutrients, the big ones, protein, carbohydrates, and fat.
Yes.
And today, Mark is going to talk about his favorite one.
Favorite one, and in my mind, again, it's everybody's different, but in my mind, it's one that's really important. As I mentioned last time, it's really important as you get older.
Okay, sure, yes.
And that is proteins.
There you go.
So I'm a huge fan of protein.
I am too. It's delicious.
It is. I think to me, it's you know, you always hear that the others, that carbs are much more delicious, and yes, they do have some very good qualities.
Not sometimes, by themselves,
sometimes,
usually.
I know, but because sometimes it's not the ones that have the best taste are the ones that are not the best.
Yeah,
for you.
Like you're talking like a pizza is a carb or pasta is a carb, but what really makes it good is the butter and the sauce and all the stuff on it. It's so I feel like carbs a lot of times take some extras, but protein. It's just good on its own.
Protein to me is like kind of the rock. It's the catalyst. It's the foundation.
It is the energy component.
I'll listen to a lot of doctors, a lot of coaches, trainers, and they're always saying, when you have your meal, you want to get your foundation first. When you're building a building, what's the most important part of a building?
Foundation.
The foundation, because everything is built on that. Yeah. And proteins act a little bit differently than carbs and fats do. And we'll get to that a little bit later. But a protein is basically, it's made up of what they call a lot of amino acids.
Okay.
And if you remember that from your way back in your science,
a
lot longer for me than science class, but amino acids are like building blocks.
Okay.
So they all work together, and I think there's 11, but they have what they call essential amino acids. And I've even read that, there's only one, there's the biggest essential macronutrient is protein.
That makes sense.
Because what it does is it provides energy at a certain level, but what it really helps you do is it helps you build.
Okay.
And recover.
Sure.
And restore.
Because every time we lift weights, we're breaking down our muscles so they can build back better.
Exactly.
Like they can build themselves up.
It's like whenever you're putting something together, you've got to put all the pieces together to make it strong.
Right.
So if you're going to build a wall, you've got to have what goes into your mortar, and then you've got your bricks. So
sure.
Everything has to work together.
Gotcha.
So okay. Amino acids within the protein molecules are what helps you build that.
So it's essential for life. These are the basics that everybody needs.
Yes. Yes. Got it.
Without them, we can't live.
Right.
Okay. It's easy enough.
As I get older, and I'm in my 50s now, and yeah. I'm looking at things, I'm like, okay, I've got to get my protein. So I will find all kinds of ways whenever I eat a meal, how can I get my protein in first?
To always so always, oh, protein first.
I do protein. Okay. I'm not saying I eat it first, but whenever you go,
I had in my head you eat your steak first and then you have your veggies.
Well, when I was younger and I had my lunch boxes, when I used to take my lunch box, I would eat my, I section everything off.
Oh, okay.
I don't do that anymore. But I only eat one thing at a time.
Okay, I'm one of those. My Thanksgiving plate, I eat one thing at a time, and things can't touch. So I get that. I'm still there. What? It's just I know it all gets combined in your stomach. I get it. It's just
You enjoy the taste of each
exactly. Each I want the flavors to be on their own.
Yeah.
To enjoy each special flavor. But anyway. All right. Enough of that weirdness. Okay.
I've tried to wonder, are there times when protein can get a bad rap? Can you eat too much protein? I've heard some coaches say that protein's kind of like that free macronutrient.
Oh, really?
Now, last time we talked about calories.
We did. Yeah.
And so you're wondering, how do calories and how does a measurement of a calorie and a measurement of a macronutrient fit together?
Okay. Well, I know that some macronutrients have more calories for their like size or weight.
Right. Okay. Right. So you're probably looking at it. So if I turn something over and say, or if I look at it and say, I'm supposed to have 2,000 calories a day.
Sure.
That's my energy that I'm taking in.
Okay.
But then you got to figure out, okay, well, how does this macro like protein fit into it? How do the carbs and fats fit into it?
Right.
Well, each gram of a macronutrient has so many calories per gram.
Ah, okay.
So if I said that right. If you're looking at a gram of protein.
Okay.
A gram of protein has 4 calories.
Oh, okay.
Has 4 calories of energy.
Does it matter what kind of protein? Like beef versus chicken versus?
No. It's just whatever that gram, whatever. Period. If it is a protein food. Okay. If it provides protein and it's built in the amino acids. We'll talk about some of the foods.
Okay.
As well, because that's a good point of what is a protein? Am I eating a protein?
Right.
If you're eating something that comes from a package or a box, you can turn it over and you can see, you've got your little nutrition label there and it shows how many, shows fat up top and then it's broken down by saturated fat. Then you go down to a couple of micronutrients we talked about and then you've got your sugars and then of sugars, what's fiber?
Right.
And then you've got
and then
you've got the added sugars, some type of added sugars in them. Yep. Those are the ones we want to talk about in the next ones what to stay away from.
Sure.
And then the bottom of the nutrition label always shows the protein.
Right.
I don't know why they put it at the bottom because to me, I think it needs to become at the top. whenever I pick up something that is packaged, I go to the bottom first.
Okay.
And I work my way up.
Ah, okay.
So I want to see how much protein am I going to get? And That's where I kind of struggle with a packaged or processed type food is that you may a Snickers bar can come and say protein packed.
Right. Yes.
And it could have 10 grams of protein in that Snickers bar. And you're thinking, well, if I'm supposed to get, say, 150 grams of protein a day, that's 10. So I'm almost, I'm getting there.
It's something.
That's the part is that when you ask about are all proteins the same?
Right.
It depends on what percentage of that food is protein.
Oh, okay.
If you look at it and I'll sometimes do some math. If I say, hey, it's a 200 calorie food and it's got this many grams of protein, this many grams of carbs and this many grams of fat, what percentage is the protein of that.
Right.
And so I want to look at it as if it's a meal.
Okay.
Is it a higher percentage of the food I'm eating?
So you want protein as the biggest proportion?
Right.
Okay.
Right.
I see.
So if I go and I grab a 6-ounce chicken breast.
Sure.
It's maybe a little bit bigger than
your palm.
The palm of my hand. It's probably just a little bit bigger. That's probably about 4 ounces. So 6-ounce chicken breast. That's pretty much chicken breast is pretty much mostly protein.
Sure.
There's going to be a little bit of a fat in there. The darker the meat, the higher concentration of fat, but it's still going to have a high concentration of protein.
Okay.
So what I like to look at is, are there single ingredient foods
okay.
that I can look at for my protein
source? Eliminate the math.
Right.
Just go for a single origin food.
So if you're thinking of what constitutes a single protein source, what do you immediately think of?
Steak.
Steak. It has four, and it can add legs.
Yeah.
That's the way I like to look at the
add legs. Oh, yeah, there you go.
You know, the biggest protein sources had legs.
Meat.
Or gills.
Or gill, yeah. Mm.
You know, a seafood person?
No, not really. No.
Okay. Yeah, I like a good, you know, we'll go to a store and buy some salmon or something every once in a while.
That's always camping food in my head. Like smoked oysters and sardines, that's what you take camping and you don't really eat them. Mom never allowed us to eat them in the house.
We've talked about sardines before, and we may lose some listeners on this one. But sardines, I've read that sardines, like if you've had a lot of exertion and you've got to recover, it could be a workout. It could be I was up in Lynchburg this last week, and those guys are packing out bread constantly.
Man.
And they say that sardines is actually a great recovery food.
Really?
Because it's got a lot. It's got so much of the essential amino acids in it.
And it's got a lot of omega-3s.
It's got a lot of omega-3s in it, and it's great for building back.
Okay.
It's for bones. You know, we talked about, I was thinking about protein for muscle.
Right.
Which is great. I would like to be able to sustain as much as I can as I get older.
Because
older people, as we age, we have what's called sarcopenia.
Okay.
Can set in.
Okay. So you lose more muscle?
It's kind of a wasting away of muscle.
Okay.
I can't remember the statistics, but I probably need to bring it back.
Yeah.
At the age of 40, you start losing a certain percentage of muscle every year.
Oh my, at 40? I didn't realize it started that. Okay.
Yes.
And I do know that the older you get, the less you absorb the protein that you eat. Because that was always...
It's not as easily digestible.
It's not as easily digested and absorbed by your body. So you have to eat more to get the same amount of protein in your muscles.
Okay.
So I do know that. I remember when we were doing research for my granddad after he had his stroke. That was something we stumbled on.
Hmm.
I don't know.
That is good to know.
Yeah.
So I guess I need to eat more.
There you go.
All right.
More than you think.
I will take that.
Challenge accepted. Mark's on it. Yeah.
But I like to vary my sources of protein.
Sure.
I mean, I eat, as I told you before, I eat a lot of tuna.
Yep.
That's actually my lunch that's going to be going to when I get done.
it's a little late for lunch.
Yeah.
Late lunch.
I just kind of graze.
Okay. I'm getting ready for dinner over here.
So, the single source foods, beef, chicken,
pork,
lamb, seafood, if you're interested in that. What else? Can you get protein from non-meat sources?
You can, but it won't have all the required amino acids that your body needs.
Exactly.
I've learned that, yes. So you can have your lentil pasta, but it doesn't really count for all the protein.
You know, it's so funny. You know, I like protein powders. I do get my protein, whey protein powders. But sometimes I had tried a plant-based.
Okay. Yeah.
But pea protein.
Yeah.
And I always, you know, I go back to my old days of not eating my green peas. And I'm like, you got these little green peas. How in the world? But they have, I think pea protein has a larger number of the essential amino acids of any of the
plant-based. Than any other vegetables. Okay. That's good to know.
So, you know, if I get home and we've got peas for dinner, I'm like, well, I'm going to eat my peas. It's providing protein. I look at all my meals from a protein perspective. Do I eat a salad every night when I get home? Yeah, I fix myself a big salad every night when I get home. But the next thing I touch is a protein.
I don't mess with any of that.
Maybe one day I'll learn.
Yes.
But see, I grew up not eating any vegetables. So I feel like in my 50s, 40s and 50s, I've been trying to make up for the first however many years up until I was like 20 that I did not eat vegetables.
Okay. Yeah.
So I'm just kind of, maybe I'll grow out of it.
Yeah.
Eat a large source of meat.
Okay.
And I mentioned this before. My kids and I have struggled with my wife eating a lot of protein. Well,
She doesn't eat protein?
She will not. She eats protein.
Okay.
But she feels like she... And this is one thing I want to make sure that we all, as we get older, they say our metabolism can slow down.
Oh, yeah.
It does, But I think we have the ability to manage a lot of that.
Oh, okay. So you're saying some of this is self-inflicted?
I think so.
Okay.
I mean, I think we have the opportunity to kind of manage that level of energy.
Sure.
So I think she feels like that if she doesn't need, as much protein as maybe she probably does.
And I guess
that kind of goes back to, I know we're kind of skipping around, but there's a whole lot that we both have been kind of in our heads for a long period of time. And so hopefully we'll all get it out. But I think that's probably one of the big questions is okay, we kind of know some of the protein sources and we'll get back to some of that. But a person may be listening and saying, so how much protein do I need?
Right. Yeah. How much protein? I mean, I know what I eat, but I'm doing a carnivore elimination diet to deal with some allergies. So my needs are very different from most normal people.
Well, if you're doing that, I know we discussed that in the last podcast.
Yeah.
If you're doing primarily a carnivore diet, you're probably, I know you don't measure, but you're getting a certain number of calories, whatever that is in your diet every day.
I guess I was going to look at it from a
percentage. The majority of your caloric intake, the majority of your caloric intake, is primarily protein with some fat.
Sure.
Because beef does have some fat.
Yep.
Whatever percentage you're getting, I don't care if it's 93.7 or 80.20.
Usually my 80.20 burgers.
So you're getting a good healthy amount of good fat.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. There's a few different recommendations of how much you need to get, but the one I hear the most is 0.8 grams to 1 gram of body weight.
Ah, okay. So you do it by body
weight. Per pound. So say I weigh 180.
Okay.
So I usually try to shoot for about 160 to 180 grams of protein a day.
Okay. And how much is that?
It's quite a bit.
It's quite a bit. Okay.
Yeah. So like if
180 grams. All right.
So mine consists of some protein powder.
Okay.
It consists of beef, chicken, seafood. Hopefully we'll keep some listeners on here, but if you haven't tried it, it's really good. Greek yogurt.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I like Greek yogurt. I like a lot of eggs.
Okay.
I eat four to five eggs a day.
Can't forget about eggs.
Four to five eggs a day. Yes.
That's impressive.
Yeah.
Is that breakfast or is that lunch or?
You know me, it could, you know, <That's>
true.
I start early, I end late.
Okay.
So, you know, but I'll usually eat them early in the morning or I'll eat them kind of at midday.
Okay.
But yeah, I'll put that with maybe some rice and some spinach and have that.
Oh, there you go.
But eggs are a great source of protein.
If you eat the whole egg,
which is the yolk, which is the really kind of the yummy stuff.
Yeah.
There's some fat in the yolk. The white is mostly the protein,
but the yolk
does have protein as well.
Sure.
But a lot of the choline, the cholesterol is in the yolk, you know, it's funny. I actually had a conversation with Chris Gibson. Chris, if you're listening, shout out to you. We had a good conversation the other day in Lynchburg and he was asking me some questions because he and I are on that leaderboard, but he's kind of in that friends challenge with me on the Virgin Pulse and I can't get ahead of him, but he's packing out a whole lot more bread during the day than I am.
Gotcha.
So thanks again, Chris, for all you do. But we were talking about, because we did the biometric up there,
right,
and he was talking about his wellness numbers and cholesterol and talking about, you know, trying to keep it down. And I let him know that this is from my perspective. Again, this is something that happened to me, is that my cholesterol had shot up a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
And the doctor called me back and he said, don't change your eating. He said, keep eating your eggs. And he said, are you taking an over-the-counter fish oil?
Oh, okay.
And I was. And again, this is from me. I told Chris, I said, this is what made. I said, don't take it. Check with your doctor.
Yes.
But I said, this was with me. And the doctor told me to stop taking my over-the-counter fish oil tablet.
Really?
But keep eating your eggs. I did that for a year. My cholesterol went way back down to normal.
Really?
Like probably the best it had been in 5 years. And I kept eating my eggs.
Huh. Okay.
I do eat oatmeal.
Okay.
I know you always hear oatmeal helps the cholesterol.
Yep.
But I do have oatmeal as well. So I'm kind of boring, but I do. And my wife, I do meal prep, and so at night. And so my wife looked last night. She saw on the stove. She goes, changing it up a little bit.
Uh-oh, what'd you do?
Not much. It's the same thing.
Okay.
I guess I didn't have as much energy expended this morning. Usually I'll work out in the morning.
Right.
But this morning I wasn't. So I didn't really need all that
all the calories.
Energy to kind of bring back in.
Oh, okay.
So I just made eggs.
Gotcha.
But one thing I want us to make sure that we, as before we kind of end the protein talk, is what do we, how do we want to approach protein? What do we want to stay away from? There's still a lot of processed protein out there.
Do you recommend people have protein with every meal? A protein source of some sort.
I highly recommend it.
Okay.
Because, I do too. You know,
you don't feel full without protein.
No, I mean, if you can get 30 to 40 grams of protein in a meal.
Sure.
And you have four meals at least through the day, you're going to get the majority of what you want.
Yeah.
Now, one thing I have heard is that if you weigh about 200 pounds or less, you want to go with that 0.8 to 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight.
Okay.
But if I'm, say, a few more pounds over that,
uh-huh.
and you're thinking, well, do I need to get 250 grams of protein or 300 grams of protein? Probably not. And at that point, they say kind of if you maybe a little bit over a couple hundred pounds,
uh-huh.
then you probably want to look at it based on what's your lean,
okay,
lean
so look
body
at it,
mass.
Do the math based on what your goal weight would be.
Yeah, kind of like, okay. yeah, your goal weight
yeah.
or lean body mass.
Gotcha.
I think,
okay.
I mean, I think for anybody, if you're above 200 pounds, I think a good 200 grams of protein would probably be, because protein is the most filling.
Sure. Yes, it is.
You know, yeah. fat is very filling. Carbs fill you up for just a little bit, but of the macronutrients that we have, protein is the most filling. So that's the reason
and
they
it
say
keeps you full for a while.
Start with protein
yeah.
and then build everything after that.
Okay. Yeah. I'm good with that.
You know, one thing I've heard is when you do your protein and if you're staggering your foods,
yep.
protein first, and then if you have vegetables, and then your carbs.
Okay.
So then if you're eating a full
so
plethora
protein and
on your
fats,
plate.
And then veggies and then carbs.
Right. So fill up on the protein.
Yeah.
Vegetables are usually a lot of fiber. So then you'd have
Makes
the fiber.
Sense.
And then if you have room, then you'd have the carbs.
Okay.
What's the damaging thing is if you ever go to a restaurant, there's two different, depending on the restaurant, they're going to bring out something to you. One would be
bread.
Bread.
Or Mexican restaurant
and chips.
My love, yes.
Two damaging foods.
Very.
They can really ruin a good protein meal.
Oh, man,
meal.
It'll kill
They're
any
good.
Diet known to man.
But it's always wonders, like, why do they bring that out first? Now, what if they brought out a hunk of meat as your appetizer?
That'd be pretty awesome.
Yeah, I agree. So
what would that
change? The hunk of meat restaurant?
It'd change, you wouldn't fill up on junk.
No, you wouldn't.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's the hard part is that, you know, if someone brought out, you know, six pieces of plain chicken breast and just put them as an appetizer out there. People would look at it and go, well, why would I want that? But when they bring the bread that smells really good out first,
right.
and you're hungry because you're going out to eat, so
right.
that's the first thing you're drawn to. There's not as much, now there may be a little protein in there, but again, if I look and calculate the percentage of protein per calorie I'm eating,
sure.
or per set of calories, it's going to be really low.
Okay.
So is that something that is going to benefit me? So maybe a takeaway from this is, the takeaway is, when I'm eating something, what am I looking to build? Am I looking to build?
Okay.
Is this going to be nourishing for me?
Sure.
And I think we could probably end every of these series of podcasts with that same
yeah,
thing.
Yeah, absolutely. And I was just listening to a podcast talking about how insulin resistance and diabetes actually causes us to lose muscle or not be able to gain muscle.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm sure that's something that, I think they say 80% of Americans have some sort of metabolic dysfunction.
Yes, heard
and
that.
So, you know, what? How do we have to really focus on protein because our muscle mass is essential to keeping our insulin in check, to keeping our metabolism going.
Mm-hmm.
And so this is very good. This is very, very yeah. helpful.
And the more muscle you can put on your body, the better your metabolism
Absolutely.
Will be.
Better your insulin will be, better your metabolism, all that.
Yep.
Your metabolic rate will be higher. You'll burn more
calories. Yeah, because that's what's crazy is I listen to these coaches and they're like, or trainers, and they're like, well, the more you can get your metabolism going, the more calories you can eat. So if you're wanting to lose weight, you can still eat more calories by building muscle to allow your body to use
sure.
more.
There you go.
And I'm still trying, it still baffles me, and I'm still looking towards that. I'm like, okay, how can I eat more food?
Right.
My goal is, how can I eat more food?
Yeah, absolutely.
But I want to eat the right things. And that's one thing we want to talk. That's one thing we want to talk to everybody about is how can we approach that healthy eating desire and what needs to go in our bodies. Good quality protein is a great start to any type meal and any type of. When I say diet plan, diet is basically just a way of eating. Sure. It's not a specific.
Yeah. Don't look at it as punishment
that you have to fall into.
Yeah. That's always my thing is I try really hard not to look at dieting like punishment.
Right.
It has to be a lifestyle change. So, yeah, it's crucial.
Yeah. All right. Do you think we've covered everything we can about protein? There's probably more I can, but.
Yeah. What about processed meats and like processed forms of protein? How do those fit in and what do those do for us? What do they not do for us? What do you think about those?
You do know you're touching on bacon.
I do not want to disparage bacon in any form or fashion.
Oh, my goodness. I know. We had to go there, didn't we?
Oh, we did. Okay. Just a little bit.
I think.
Okay, what's a processed meat that we can make fun of that's not bacon?
Salami?
Yeah, there you go. Bologna.
Bologna.
Bologna sandwich, all right?
Hot dogs?
Yes, hot dogs. Okay. How many bologna sandwiches can I eat a week? Let's go with that. How about that?
I'll say this. Enough to enjoy, but not enough to make you keep wanting them.
Ah, okay.
So, right. I mean,
because they do come with a lot of extra sodium and a lot of things that are going to.
A lot of things we don't know what they come
that's
with.
That's probably true.
That's the thing about with hot dogs and some of the foods. We don't really know. But, you know, you got pepperoni.
Oh, yeah.
Salami.
Yeah.
I hate to throw it in there, but bacon is kind of.
Yeah, technically.
I love bacon. Bacon is very good. But I realized that my body, that was one of those things that I thought I could eat a lot of on the last episode we talked about that I kind of put on a lot more weight because I thought I can eat as much bacon as I want.
There you go.
But you can't eat bacon with other things. Now, if I'm just going to eat bacon and that's all I'm going to eat, my body's going to get full from bacon and it's not going to want anymore.
Sure.
But if I keep putting, you know, something on top of it that is going to offset that bacon, it's not going to work well for
me. Gotcha.
A lot of times when you have bacon, you may have biscuits or you may have other things that.
Sure.
And that's one thing I want, you know, we'll probably talk about on these next two macronutrient podcasts is what can go well together, what doesn't need to go together.
Right. Sure.
Because they can backfire.
Absolutely. Okay.
So again, start with protein and then build from there.
Start with clean protein.
Clean protein.
Clean protein. Try not to have processed protein at every meal.
Yep.
All right.
Yeah.
I'll see if I can.
Now, if you don't eat a lot of meat.
Right.
Beans are very good.
Yeah.
Beans have a good source. They provide a lot of fiber, carbs, fat, protein, but they're very good.
Yeah.
If you're in nuts and seeds, they have their.
Right.
I would not. We have this ongoing argument at the house, and I think it's more of like a I gotcha kind of thing, or they kind of stabbing, you know, kind of agony at each other. But you know, sometimes I mean, as much as I like peanut butter and peanuts, it's not what I would call a primary protein source.
Sure.
Again, turn the back of the peanut butter jar over, and then look and see the calories. Take your 4 grams.
How many added sugars?
Yes, exactly.
Yep.
And you can buy the all natural peanut butter.
You can,
which we do.
Yep.
But it's still, if you take some of the all the three macronutrients together, it's not going to be your ideal protein source.
That makes sense.
So yeah. I just annihilated peanut butter and bacon within a 2-minute period.
Oh, man,
so
Mark,
I'm hoping everybody comes back and listens to the rest of these podcasts. We'll get some good information out there.
There you go. Okay. All right. Sounds good.
All right. I think we got it all.
I think so. Wonderful.
Well,
thank you. We know about protein now.
Thanks for your time. Appreciate
thank you.
It. Look forward to the next episodes.
Yes.
All right.
Anytime.
Until next time, stay safe and take care.